Hello, what's up? Welcome to a new quick edit video. As some of you may have noticed, I didn't upload the last two times. That's because I was a week traveling through the Dolomites in Italy and just exploring the Alps a little bit. Now I'm back and I want to start the editing with this shot which I took from the Seiser Alm just above St. Ulrich. And for the editing I will be using Adobe Photoshop only and maybe make use of the Nik Collection plugin as well. But the base raw image is already looking pretty good. So before I go on, let's first take a look at the before and after images. Alright, here we are in the camera raw editor of Photoshop and I want to head on first to the optics tab. Here I'm just activating those two settings real quick, then I'm heading back to the top. And right away I want to change the profile to Adobe Landscape, which will give me some more base saturation, and that's what I like for this shot. Also I like those subtly warm highlights. I think I can enhance them a little more by changing the white balance to daylight. And then let's see how I'm going to balance the exposure. Right now it does look pretty good. If you're taking a closer look to the histogram, I can push the whites a little more. I also think reducing the highlights might give me some more details. Then let's also play around with the shadows. I think I want to increase them here. But not too much, I still want to have some nice contrast in here. And speaking of contrast, let's also increase it just a little bit. Now I want to add some more sharpness and detail, and I can simply do that by increasing the texture and of course the clarity, which works great on those mountainscapes. And I could even add some dehaze for some more contrast. Okay, so I think that's it for the basic adjustments. Now I want to do some local adjustments. And for this I'm using gradiated filters and I mainly want to work on the grass in the foreground. So I have this bigger gradiated filter which covers more of the grass. And here I simply want to add some more detail by increasing the clarity. And this makes the grass just look much better. Then I'm using this smaller radial filter to add some more shadows to the very near foreground. So here I'm just dropping the exposure. Okay, nice. That's it for the local adjustments already. Then let's do some color grading. And for this image, the luminance tab is really important since I can play around with the blue tones and thus make the sky look much, much better. That basically means I'm dropping the blue luminance quite a bit and it makes the sky that much more dramatic. Okay, nice. Then I'm increasing the green luminance, which will brighten up the grass and the trees in the foreground, and I'm even increasing the yellow luminance, which basically has the same effect. Then let's switch to the saturation tab, and of course the sky is way too saturated, so let's drop the blue saturation. Okay, and maybe let's also drop the greens a little bit. Alright. For the split toning, I'm using the highlights to apply warm color tones. But I only want to apply a subtle effect here, so I'm using a rather low saturation. Okay, and then I'm not using the shadows this time, but I want to go on with the color grading all the way down in the calibration tab. And as usual, I'm just playing around with all those sliders. In this case, I'm dropping the blue primary hue and increase its saturation. Then let's increase the red primary hue as well as the green one. And then also increase their saturation. Alright, and then finally let's also do some sharpening. And then let's open it in Photoshop. First, I want to crop the image a little bit because the top is pretty much unnecessary. So I'm hitting the C button to bring up the crop tool. And then I'm holding down shift to keep the ratio. And I just take away a bit from the left and the top. Okay. And then let's see, I think I want to remove a few clouds like this one. Also, I think there's a sensor spot. And then let's get rid of the top cloud right there. By the way, I used the spot healing brush to remove those. As you can see, this works pretty good. And now we have a nice clear sky. I think that's pretty much it. I still want to remove this fence in the grass. Again, I am just using the spot healing brush. Now I think that's pretty much it for the editing. I still want to take a look at some Nick Collection filters in case there's something to improve here. And I think I'm actually going with the polarization filter here. And this will just improve the colors some more and make the sky slightly darker. I just don't want to overdo this, so I'm using a rather low strength. Okay. And at this point I want to stop the editing, so I hope this was interesting and helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments, and thank you very much for watching this video.